You have already used an augmented matrix a couple of times in order to solve a linear system. But we haven't talked about a matrix yet. This was not a problem though. Intuitively, it is quite clear what is meant with a matrix. Now it is time to be a bit more precise and to see what we exactly mean with a matrix. Furthermore, we need a few conventions. For example, what's a zero matrix, the identity matrix, and the transpose of a matrix. I will learn all of this in just one video. Let's take a look. Well, matrix for us, for now, is a rectangular array of numbers. A is called an M3 times N2 matrix, so M times N matrix. Where are the M and the N? Well, the M, the first one, relates to the height of the matrix, and the N, the second one, to the width. And then we denote all the numbers in the array. We start here with A11, and then we continue to the right, A11, A12, A13, up till A1n. That's what's called the first row of the matrix. Then we go to the second row, and the third row, and so on, until the last row. The last row will start with AM1, and then AM2, AM3, up till AMN. So that's how you can write down a matrix. This the horizontal arrays of numbers are called the rows of the matrix. And here, the vertical ones are called columns, just as it's called, for example, in Excel. Of course, it's quite cumbersome to write a matrix like this because it takes a lot of room. So often the matrix is denoted like this as a sequence of its columns. So A1 is the first column of the matrix, A2 the second one, up till AN. So often the matrix is written like that. So let us do one example. Here we have our matrix A. Height is 3 and the width is 2. So we have a 3 by 2 matrix. So you could write also as A1, A2. And let's take a look at the numbers. What is A3, 2? So we go to 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2. So A3, 2, we arrive at the 5 over here. What would happen if we try to find A2, 3? Well, then we go 1, 2 to the second row, 1, 2, 3 to the third column, which does not exist. So that does not exist. And if you write it as a sequence of columns, the first column would be 1, 2, 6, and the second column, A2, would be 4, 3, 5. So that's a few of the conventions. Let's look at some special matrices. The zero matrix is a matrix containing only zeros. Okay, that's a bit silly, but there it is. More importantly, the identity matrix. We here write as I3, which means that we have a 3 by 3 matrix. Similarly, you have I2, 2 by 2 matrix, or I5, a 5 by 5 matrix. And what is this matrix? It has ones over here on the diagonal and zeros everywhere else. So that is what is called the identity matrix. Then, finally, let us look at the transpose of a matrix. How do we get the transpose of a matrix A? Well, by interchanging rows and columns. So if you start with your matrix A over here, you get the transpose as follows. You take the first column, 1, 2, 6, and then you turn that into the first row. And then you take the second column, 4, 3, 5, and turn that in the second row, and so on, and so on. And of course, if you have your A transpose, you take the transpose again. Well, taking transpose is interchanging rows and columns. So if you interchange rows and columns and do it again, then you're of course back at your original matrix. Well, sometimes taking the transpose of a matrix doesn't change the matrix. That can happen. We see already an example on the slide over here. If you take the transpose here of your identity matrix, you interchange rows and columns, well, they are the same. So the transpose of the identity matrix is just the same as the identity matrix itself. So that can happen, but in general, the taking transpose, of course, will change the matrix. So now you have seen some of the basics of matrices.